To prove that I wrote to Ian Paisley, there is a copy of the letter I wrote to Ian Paisley. And when Ian Paisley was replied from Anne Kennelly, there's Ian Paisley's there. Anne Kennelly, as she stated to all up and down there and to everybody that she went to, that my brother was being monitored constantly, being looked after, cared for. Well, this is what I was sending her. These are the photographs I was sending her and to people. There's a man who went from 15 stone and no terminal illness. He was starved. He kept telling me, I'm starving, I'm dying, I'm doing my penance. Help me, I'm dying. And everybody I turned to, I had no way would they help me. A deaf ear, any politician, as I showed you there, the politicians, even Mary McAleese. There's me telling Mary McAleese in 06, when my brother was still alive.
Hold it from the top, can't see you, yeah.
When my brother was still alive, I am telling the President of Ireland to help my brother. If that was a dog, I'm a zoo, the dog's life would have been saved. But my brother was being locked up by church and state because he was homeless. And my brother didn't know what was going on or what was happening to him because he'd never had a life. He, look at him, a man, that is my brother there. A big man that goes from that, sorry about this, to one photograph, the big photograph, to the big photographs. That photograph.
Mary.
To this. That. That is my brother, Christopher Smith. And that is the same man there. Now, that is the man with no terminal illness, starved. And they verified it and clarified it in what you call this CUH. And I myself got him into CUH. Now, as I was calling all these ambulances, I was actually told my brother would be put somewhere where I'd never find him. Christy didn't know what was happening to him, but I was all he had in the world, and I did try my utmost best to save him. And on the particular date, the 15th of the 2nd, 07, I read out a statement for you. And this is a statement that proved to me. I'm a witness, the person's name I won't give, that Mary Smith called to my place and ran St. Stephen's Hospital, Glanmire, County Cork. A man answered the phone by the name of Peter. Mary asked to speak to her brother, who came on the phone, and her brother was not able to breathe. My brother wasn't able to breathe. Mary asked and begged Peter to call an ambulance, which was not, he said he could not wave a magic wand. I begged them again for an ambulance, which fell on deaf ears. The following morning, I got a phone call to say my brother was dead. He was not allowed into a hospital. And not alone that, I was told that if I called any more ambulances, this is why I was afraid to call for an ambulance. And these people, when I went to the police, after Christy died, there was an investigation done. And that man, that gentleman and his father, who witnessed me making that phone call to save my brother's life, who shouldn't be dead. He was all I had in the world. And they refused him, as a human right should have, an ambulance. And that's why he's dead today. In the secure lockup, with no air, doors and windows locked. And that's where Christy found his death. 60 years in a lockup, secure lockup. Sorry, 40 years in a secure lockup. Over the dirty, filthy church and state, because my mother was an unmarried mother, and Christy and I were put into industrial schools, and because Christy was called homeless, he was put into a mental hospital. Never, never certified. Now, I have in my statement, they said that Christy died of pneumonia. Pneumonia was brought on him. And it actually says also in CUH hospital, they didn't know how the weight loss was going. I have unfortunately the document here, I cannot find it, but it's down in black and white. They don't know how on earth he was losing the weight. But two doctors did say that he was malnutrition. And when they said it to me, I said, yes, Christy's been starved. He kept saying, I'm starving, I'm dying, help me. I am doing my penance, help me. I says, Christy, I'm doing everything I can. I'm doing all my best. I can't do any more than what I'm doing. Why let this happen? He was my brother. He was all I had in the world. They took my mother from me. And they left me with nothing. They took my home from me. They took my life. I never had a life. And most of all, they took the person I loved most in the world. My brother, Christopher Smith, whose rights were taken off him. Everything. What is the government for? Is the government there to torture people? I'd refer that phrase that. To neglect people. To let people die of neglect, medical neglect. Everybody's entitled to a hospital. You saw my brother's photographs. He had no terminal illness whatsoever. He died at 15, from 15 stone. Just 8 stone, 6 stone. And yet he couldn't even breathe. And his last words to me was, there's no God. He couldn't breathe. And he said to me, there's no God. How could Christy believe there was a God there? When his mother was taken from him at 5 and a half, he was put into Greenmount. Then raped by the Christian Brothers. Then because he was homeless, put into a mental hospital to die. For the rest of his life, never to see a life. He never had a life he was supposed to live. And all his rights, he died of cruelty, inhumanely. This is what I give my statement to the police. He was treated inhumanely, neglect to a defenseless man who never had a voice, never had a voice in this world. And I made that phone call on the 15th of the 2nd, 07. And at 9:45 on the 16th of the 2nd, my brother was dead. But I tried in vain to do everything in my power to save my brother. But every day since Christy died, I can't have peace. Because this should have never happened. The state, the church let it happen. Why did I leave this man die? Is it because the church and state wanted them dead to shut their mouths to cover up their dirty work so nobody know? How many more people in this world are like Christy? When I went down to Unit 5, the lockup as it's called, in Glenmar, in St. Stephen's in Glenmar, I've seen lots and lots more people on the same side of Christy. Cruelty to them. Nobody knows what's going on behind closed doors here in Ireland still today. It's still going on. And as a matter of fact, I have it on the paper here when Christy died. You see when Christy died? That's what it says. And it actually says on the paper, it was on after Christy died, and it, on the end of it, it says, torture is going on behind closed doors in Ireland's institutions to this date. And this date was the 8th August the 24th, 2008. So somebody should be brought to justice for the death of my brother through neglect, medical neglect, that should have been avoided, all because I went to the medical council to remove a psychiatrist. He took his badness out of Christie, and I am going to tell you something else. I was told that day on the 3rd of the 2nd, 07, when I went in, that Christie was put in there because I went to the medical council. And the same person, Eugene Morgan, put him in there. And I won't give the person's name, told me verbally that day on the 3rd of the 2nd, 07, and Christie was dead on the 16th of the 2nd, 07. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you indeed.